A very warm afternoon to all. Welcome to the 13 days virtual lecture series for the students of BA 3rd SEM Compulsory English. On behalf of Mahila Mahavidyalaya Nandanvan Nagpur, I welcome you all. The purpose of this lecture series is to provide assistance in the understanding of curriculum to the students. We have been going through the phase of pandemic altogether. To let the education process go on and to reach out to the students, we are going live on YouTube, where students can get the benefit of lectures anytime and anywhere. So students make the most out of it, as we have amongst us Dr. Anup Gumle, sir. Sir has presented and published many research papers in seminars and conferences. He has with him teaching experience of 10 years. He has a specialization in Indo-Anglian literature. Welcome, sir. And the proposed topic of today's is Yusuf by James Russell Lowell. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. It's a pleasure once again to be with Mahila Mahavidyalaya Nandanvan in this 13 yes. days virtual lecture series. This is Dr. Anup Gumle from RV District Wardha. Dear students, today we are going to discuss a very wonderful poem by James Russell Lowell. This American poet is well known for his academic capabilities. What he has shared with the society between 1819 to 1921. In this small span of his life, he has worked as a critic, as a diplomat, as a poet, as an essayist. He was a professor of modern language at Harvard for many years. He is known for his many works, his articles and essays in number of research journals, periodicals. Mainly, he worked for the abolishment of the slavery. You know, slavery system was there in the European countries, in America, in Africa, and in South America. So this was a blot to humanity, and Lowell has worked prominently to abolish this slavery. His anti-slavery views are visible in his many poems. Particularly, when we talk about this poem, Yusuf, I remember a very famous poem in Merchant of Venice, where Portia, the poem is titled, The Quality of Mercy. Dear friends, mercy is a gift given by the nature, by the God to human beings. No doubt, even animals show mercy. And when it comes to human beings, naturally, it is our responsibility. When we say that we are the most intelligent community on this planet, we must show mercy to others. In Quality of Mercy, Portia requests the villain to show the mercy to her client. She advocates the cause and she tells the importance of mercy. In that poem, there is a last line where Portia says, Quality of mercy is twice blessed. It blesses those who show and those also who receive. Daya, sneha ki bhavna, maaf kar dena kisi ko. Ye ek aisa vardaan hai मानव जाति को, जिसमें मर्सी दिखाने वाला भी भगवान का आशीर्वाद पाता है और जिसको मर्सी दिखाई जाती है उसको भी आशीर्वाद मिलता है. सो हियर इन दिस इंट्रोडक्टरी पेज वी कैन रीड ऑल ऑफ अस हैव बीन हर्ड बाय पीपल एट सम टाइम और द अदर. हाउ डिड वी रिएक्ट इन सच सिचुएशंस? It is very obvious that we swear revenge. Main badla lunga. We want to take revenge. We keep the flame of that revenge burning till the opportunity presents itself. Unless and until we get the opportunity, we say, or we continuously go on thinking about revenge. But what is the sanity? What is the saneness? What is the calmness of mind? What are the saintly features? In this poem, the central character of this poem, Yusuf, shows that sanity, that mercy, that act of forgetfulness, forgiveness shown by Yusuf to the murderer of his firstborn, who has been murdered by Ibrahim. And that Ibrahim comes to his tent and he gives the shelter, he gives him food, water, security, safety. But in the next morning, what happens? Does the act of forgiveness is there? What is the action taken by Yusuf to the person who has murdered his only son, first son? What he does, that is very important. And we are going to study the same thing through this small poem. इस छोटी सी कविता में से हमको ये सीखने को मिल रहा है कि जो माफ करने का जो इंसानियत है, ह्यूमैनिटी है, यूसुफ कैसे बताते हैं और उसके बाद में क्या होता है वो हमको यहाँ पर देखना है. द पोएम स्टार्ट्स लाइक दिस. इट इज थर्ड पर्सन नैरेटिव पोएम. द पोएट इज टेलिंग अस द स्टोरी व्हाट हैपेंड in the tent of Yusuf. This poem is set in Arabian countries, somewhere in United Arab Emirates or somewhere in Saudi Arabia or wherever we can say. The land is deserted, very few people are there, and the laws of desert, they are very stern, very strict. Various people live in their tents and they wish safety and security wherever they go. In that situation, what happens? That a stranger came one night to Yusuf's tent saying, "Behold, one outcast and in dread." Outcast means a person who has been boycotted by the society. And who is in dread, who is afraid. The stranger comes to his tent. Yusuf is a very respectable gentleman. All the community, the society knows that Yusuf is a very kind-hearted person, very gentle person. And that stranger person comes to his tent and requests, "Behold, one outcast and in dread." He says that, "I am outcast. I have been boycotted by the society, by the law, by the state, by the king. And I am afraid, against whose life the bow of power is bent." The phrase is there, bow of power. Means the rulers. Power means rulers. These rulers, they are very angry with this person. And they have given some orders, perhaps, to kill that stranger. Might be he has done some heinous act, some very grave crime, and that's why the king has ordered to take his life. So he says, he tells that my life is in danger. Any time the soldiers of the king, they will come and they will kill me. Who flies and hath not where to lay his head. Now this word hath, it is old English. The poetic liberty is taken there. Poets they can use archaic words, old words, and we people in our day-to-day conversation, we do not use this word, hat. Actually, it is hat. So that person says that I have no hair to lay my head. Now, what can I do? So I come to thee for shelter. Again, the word thee, T-H-E-E. It means you. Thee, thy, and thou. These three words are there. They are representing you, Y-O-U. So he says that I came to thee for shelter and for food. To Yusuf called through all our tribes, the good. That stranger who is afraid that his life might be taken at any instance. So he says that I have come to you for shelter and for food. Because I know that all our tribes, all the people of the community, they know that Yusuf is a gentleman. He is known for his kind-heartedness. So that person says that you give me shelter and I have no hope. Now, what is the reaction of Yusuf? What does Yusuf say? Actually, when Yusuf comes to know that the soldiers of the king, they have been searching for this person. He must be a criminal. And in that situation, it is very dangerous to give him shelter. But Yusuf is a gentleman. Yusuf knows to give shelter to the needy. And Yusuf performs his duties. He never fails to perform his duties. He is a kind-hearted person who is known as a good person in all his tribes. He answers very kindly. His words have been quoted. This tent is mine, said Yusuf, but no more than it is God's. He says that no doubt this is my tent, but more than that, it is God's. Come in and be at peace. He says that don't bother. Come in. This is God's tent. All of us, we have been made by the God. And you are also welcome here. Come in. Freely shall thou partake of all my store. Partake means have. You can have. It must be noted that in the desert areas, there are no food reserves, no water. For miles together, for thousands of miles, there are no villages. So wherever you go, you have to take the help of other people. Here, Yusuf says to me, freely shall thou partake of all my store, whatever food, water, or the things I am having, you can share them. As I of his. Now the his, H-I-S. His, H is written capital. It represents God. When some letter is written in the capital, in the middle of the sentence. In the second line, you can see God's, the G is written capital. So Yusuf says, freely shall thou partake of all my store, as I of his who buildeth over these, our tents, his glorious roof of day and night. He says that the God is almighty. God is all powerful. And what he has done? He has built it. Again, old English. The word should have been built past participle. But in the old English, the poets used these types of words, buildeth. So he says that over my tent, there is a roof of day and night. And that roof is very glorious. It is full of glory. It is full of mercy. God has created this day and night. And at whose door none ever yet heard me. These lines are very important. Yusuf says that God is full of mercy. He never says no to anyone. Whoever comes to his shelter for help, he forgives all his guilts. And that's why this is God's tent. My dear friend, you can come in and you can share all the store I am having. You can have food, you can have water, you can have safety of life, you can rest here for the whole night. And at whose door none ever yet heard name. Name is no. Nobody in this world has been heard by the God. God is all powerful. God is almighty. We are all the children of God. You and I have been created by God. So, dear friend, please come in and share. So Yusuf entertained his guest that night and waking him day. Now again, it is before. Means before the sunrise, he wakes him up and says, here is gold. My swiftest horse is saddled for thy flight. Saddled, again, ready. In those days, there were no motorbikes. There were no cars. So people in the desert areas, they have to use camels or horses for their ride. So what this person does, Yusuf wakes him early in the day. And here is gold. He gives him some gold coins. And his swiftest means the fastest horse is ready. And he says, you take this horse and gold and you please run away from this place. Depart before the praying day grow old. Pray, P-R-Y. Praying day means people are searching for you. They may hunt you. They may find you. They may kill you. And that's why this phrase has been used. Praying day. Grow bold. Obviously, when the soldiers, they are searching for the previous night, previous day, the soldiers have worked hard. The soldiers have searched for this person. And when he was not found, they must have taken rest somewhere. Now, these soldiers, they are fresh. Their horses are fresh. And they must be following the orders of the king. And they must be in search of you. So before they reach you, before the soldiers comes to you, they finds you, you do better. You run away from this place. You run away from their eyesight. You run away from their reach. So he says, depart, run away from this place. Go away from this place before these soldiers freshen themselves up and they start searching for you. As one light, one lamp lights another, no grows less, nor grows less. So nobleness enkindleth nobleness. Now nobleness. Nobleness of the heart. He has given the simile of one lamp. When in the Diwali or when in any celebration, we lamp the lights. We lamp, first of all, first lamp, we enlighten incandescent with the matchstick. And then from that one lamp, oil lamp, we start enlightening other lamps. In the same manner, when one person shows the nobleness of heart, when one person shows the goodness, when one person shows the kindness, naturally it happens that another person also shows the same quality. The example of a lamp is given. When we lamp one light from the another, our light is doubled, nor grows less. It never grows less. So, nobleness, enkindleth nobleness. Kindle, K-I-N-D-L-E. Kindle means to enlighten. Enkindle is a verb. When we have a prefix N, we found a new verb. Okay? Here, the act of goodness shown by Yusuf has proved very helpful. Everyone knows that the person is running away, person is afraid. The soldiers of the king, power of bent, the bow of power is bent over him. At any instance, the king and his soldiers, they are ready to arrest this person. But what Yusuf has done, Yusuf has taken risk. Yusuf says that you take my fastest horse and you please run away from this position. So the same condition happened, that nobleness shown by Yusuf creates kindness, the quality of mercy is there. The next stanza is there. That inward light, the stranger's face made grand. Now we know light is there. But what is inward light? The understanding of the situation. The person realizes that Yusuf has taken great risk, and that's why that stranger's face also is made grand. His face starts shining, which shines from all self-conquest. Conquest means to be victorious. He has won over himself, all the guilts, all the crimes this person has done. Now he is feeling pity for himself and kneeling low, K-N-E-E-L-I-N-G. Knee is a part of a leg. Whenever we surrender in front of some great person, we kneel before him. That person, the stranger who has come to Yusuf's tent the previous night, he kneels. He bends over his knees. He bowed his forehead upon Yusuf's hand, sobbing, "O Sheikh, I cannot leave thee so." Again, "thee" means you. He starts sobbing. He takes Yusuf's hand in his hand. And he starts crying in a very low sound. He says that, "Yusuf, I am extremely sorry. Oh, Sheikh." Sheikh is a title there. It is a title of respect. The very rich person or very gentle person, gentleman, they are called Sheikhs. The stranger says, "Oh, Sheikh, I cannot leave thee so. In this way, I cannot leave away from this place. I will repay thee All these thou hast done. Again, thou means you. Hast means had. Whatever mercy you have shown to me, I will repay you. Now, how can this stranger, whose life itself is in danger, who has no food, no water, no shelter, how he can repay? I will repay thee all this thou hast done unto that Ibrahim who slew thy son. Now, this is the turning point of the poem. That stranger tells his name, that my name is Ibrahim, and you have shown all this mercy to that person, Ibrahim, who slew thy son. I am the person, I am the guilty person to whom you have been searching for many years, and I am guilty. I slew thy son, I have murdered your son, I have cut his neck by my sword. I have separated his head from the body, and you have shown mercy to me. O Sheikh, please pardon me. I will repay thee all this thou hast done unto that Ibrahim who slew thy son. He confesses everything. Now, whenever, I already told you, this is the turning point, this is the climax of the story. This is the highest emotional point in the poem. When we come to know that Yusuf is a very gentle-hearted person, he is a kind-hearted person. He has helped many people. He is known as Yusuf the Good. He has taken risk. And now we come a very sad event in the life of Yusuf. That Yusuf's son was murdered by some person. His name was Ibrahim, but Yusuf could not find him. For many years, for many months, Yusuf had been searching for him. Yusuf wanted perhaps to take revenge. And now that person is in front of him. To the same person, Ibrahim, Yusuf has shown mercy. Nobleness enkindleth nobleness. Yusuf's goodness has created a change in the heart, in the mind of Ibrahim, the murderer. Now Ibrahim confesses his guilt. He says that, Sheikh, you are a very gentle person and I am guilty. I am murderer. I am the man who has killed your son. So please, I will repay you all. How he will repay? How Ibrahim is ready to repay? Ibrahim is offering his life in front of Yusuf. Please kill me. Please take your revenge. Please complete your revenge. Only this is the way that I can repay you, my dear Yusuf. You are a great soul. But what Yusuf does, we already discussed that Yusuf is a very gentleman, very kind-hearted person. He is known as Yusuf the Good. Reaction of Yusuf is very noteworthy here. Why this poem is very famous and why this poem has been prescribed to a third semester of BA students. My dear friends, it is very necessary for all of us to consider this quality of mercy. What is the reply of Yusuf? He says, take thrice the gold, said Yusuf, for with thee into the desert, never to return. Yusuf says, I have given you few coins of gold. Now take thrice of it. There are ample gold coins in my tent. You take thrice. Take this gold with you and go into the desert, never to return. Do not come to my tent again. Do not come to this side of desert again. My one black thought shall ride away from me, firstborn, for whom by day and night I yearn, desire long. Every day and night I remember my firstborn. He was my first son, first child. And I loved him very much. But before some black thought comes into me, you please go away, take thrice the gold, and go away never to return. Because if some black thought comes into my heart, my all goodness will be gone. So better way, you do one thing, you take the gold and you run away as early as possible. Because it is very difficult for Yusuf to forgive the person who has killed his son. Obviously, it is a very difficult task. No one can forgive. It is the job of the saints. It is the work of the gods only. A very great people can forgive their enemies. So he says that it is better to go away from this place. My firstborn, for whom by day and night I yearn, I long for him, I remember him. Every now and then I remember my child. Balanced and just are all of God's decrees. The last sentence is there. Decrees means orders. He says that God's orders are there. And by God's orders, we do all the things. And his orders are balanced and just. Just means full of justice. Whatever God does, it is right. Once you have killed my only son, and now you have come for shelter to me, and I have given you shelter. Yesterday night, in the darkness, you cannot see my face, and that's why you did not know who I am. But in the light of the morning, you are able to see me. God has done his job. He has sent the murderer of my son to me. And by doing so, God has wiped away, God has erased all the acts of revenge from my heart. That's why Yusuf says that his orders are balanced and just. Thou art avenged. Again, art. This is the old English word for art. Thou means you. He says that you are avenged. Avenged, revenged. Revenge has been completed. My firstborn sleep in peace. He says that my firstborn, he has been buried after his death. And now he sleeps in peace. He is very calm. He is very quiet. He is not hurt now. No one, no power, no any act of crime can hurt him. He is taking his rest. And why he can sleep in peace? Because today, when I have forgiven you, that act of revenge, that feeling of revenge has vanished from my heart. And so, my firstborn, he sleeps in peace. Here are some word meanings. You can have a look. Behold means to look at something. Outcast is a person who is not accepted by other members of the society or community. Next phrase is there, who flies means a person who is running from the law. Partake of means to share in. Yusuf allows him to share, partake all his stores. Or means before, we have already discussed. Saddled here is ready for travel. Enkindled here gives birth to, develops. Nobleness, enkindled nobleness. The act of nobleness shown by Yusuf develops act of nobleness in the heart of stranger, that is Ibrahim. Sobbing means crying noisily while taking short breaths. Slew means killed. So now, again, some technical aspects are there. We can have a quick look of this technical aspect. Generally, in the poetry, there is a rhyme scheme. Now, when we see this first stanza, you can read here these last words. This tent is there and the third line is bent. Okay? The second line is dread and the fourth line is head. They rhyme with each other. Okay? Now, the fifth line is food and the sixth line is good. So, tent rhymes with bent, dread rhymes with head, and food rhymes with good. So, the rhyme scheme is there. AB, AB, and CC. Food rhymes with good. The next stanza is there. There, these last words, more rhymes with store. This correction is to be done here. In your text, it must be right. So, more rhymes with store and peace rhymes with these. Then, day rhymes with nay. In the next stanza, night, flight, gold, bold, less, nobleness. Okay? Then here is grand, low, hand, so. So grand rhymes with hand, low rhymes with so, done rhymes with sun. Then there is written, yearn, sorry, here D rhymes with me. Return rhymes with yearn, decrease, and peace. In this way, this wonderful poem is there where we learn that act of forgiveness is the greatest act in the human life. Whenever we come across this type of situation, human beings, as human beings, we must try to forgive the people. Otherwise, what will happen? That this cruelty, this act of revenge will kill ourselves. Even in the Indian philosophy, we come to know that whoever comes for a shelter, he must be forgiven. He must be given shelter. in our history, in our mythology, in our religious books, all over the world, not only in India, all over the world. Even in Christianity, we know that there is a confession box in the church where you can go and you can confess your crimes. The Father is there. He conveys your message to the God, and it is said that you are forgiven by the God. On behalf of the God, the Father of the church, the priest in the church, he forgives you. So, dear friends, it is the greatest act of forgiveness that we have learned from this small poem by James Russell Lowell. I hope even in your life, you will be ready to forgive all these types of revengeful acts. All those people who have hurt you, all those people who have done wrong with you. And only by doing so, we can say that we are the noble-hearted human beings. We must try to behave like Yusuf the good. Yusuf is just a goodness in our heart. I hope all of you will consider this, and by saying this, by making this appeal, I want to take your leave. Thank you very much, Dr. Anil Dudewar, and all the participants who have heard me. Thank you to the principal of Mahila Mahavidyalaya Nandanwan. Thank you all.
Thank you, sir. That was truly enriching lecture. Thank you so much.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you.
On behalf of Mahila Mahavidyalaya, I would like to thank our resource person, Dr. Anup Gumbe sir, for his very informative delineation of Yusuf by James Russell Lowell. Thank you, sir. I would also like to thank our principal ma'am, Dr. Vandana Bhavrikar, and Dr. Dodewar sir for organizing such a helpful series for the students. Thank you all.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.